Finally, my friends, we are coming to the last step of input analysis, the goodness of fitness. At this point, we are going to perform some formal or informal hypothesis testing on the sample that we have and the parameters that we have determined. So we have collected our data. Then we have identified the distribution, and then we have estimated the parameters of that distribution. And at this point, we have a hypothesis like that. For example, the observations that we get seem to follow normal distribution with location parameter 5 and the variance parameter 1. Or another hypothesis, for example, the interarrival times that we have collected from the supermarket seem to follow exponential distribution with rate parameter being 3.2 customers per minute, which means in every minute, on the average, 3.2 customers are arriving into the system. Or we may say the time to failure of our products seem to follow viable distribution with parameter 0, 1, and 3.2. So I do not exactly remember which one is shape or which one is scale. You can always check it. So we have viable distribution that follows this and given in, for example, yearly time units. So you see, we have such hypotheses like that in this point. Now we need to test if this hypothesis can be true or not. Remember now, we can never prove that actually this sample follows this distribution. We can never prove that. Why we cannot prove that? Because if you really want to prove that, you need to see the whole parent population. I mean, you cannot prove that with a sample. But with a sample, you can prove the opposite. At least you can prove that it does not follow these distributions. However, you know, if you want to use this model as an input model, you need to believe in the null hypothesis. Even though you cannot prove, you need to have at least no evidence to disprove it. Now, how can we test the hypothesis? If you are good at statistical analysis, you can check an informal descriptive statistic such as the QQ plot, which is the abbreviation of the quantile versus quantile plot, or theoretical quantile versus empirical quantile. And you can also use a formal methodology like the Kolmogorov-Smirnov or the chi-square test, which are the goodness of fit tests. So we are going to learn both things. Let's start with the informal way, quantile-quantile plots. What is a QQ plot or a quantile versus quantile, or sometimes called theoretical quantile versus empirical quantile? Let's explain the theoretical quantile. The theoretical quantile of a distribution is the inverse CDF of that function at that quantile width. Okay? For example, let's just say, my friends, I am interested in the 30% quantile of a distribution. So let's just explain the quantile of a distribution. So let's just say we have a distribution like that. So let's just say this is my distribution. The area under my PDF is equal to 1, you know. So what is the Q quantile of a distribution? And Q is going to be a value between 0 and 1. So I am just going to draw a line like this. So the area of this region is going to be Q, and the area of this region is going to be 1 minus Q. And here, this value, my friends, is called Q quantile of this distribution. This value is called the Q quantile of the distribution. The distribution to the lower Q percentage and the upper 1 minus Q percentage. For example, if you are interested in 80% quantile or 0.8 quantile, then you need to identify a quantile value such that the distribution is divided into two regions where the area on the left-hand side is going to be 0.80 and the area on the right-hand side is going to be 0.20. Basically, my friends, as you can see, the Q quantile of a function is the inverse CDF at Q. Just like random variate generation, right? So you plug in the random number here and you get a random variate, and you just plug in the percentage or the probability here and you get the quantile. So quantile means the inverse cumulative distribution function. But this is the theoretical quantile because the CDF is the theoretical distribution. What is the sample quantile? The sample quantile, the Q quantile of a simple random sample, is the value x which separates the sample into the lower Q percent and the upper 1 minus Q percent of the observation. So this is the sample quantile or the empirical quantile. How do I do that? How do I find that? I basically sort my observations from the smallest and largest. And let's just say if I am interested in 80% quantile or 0.8 quantile, then I need to separate the smallest 80% of my observations from the largest 20% of my observations. This is called the sample quantile. The other one is theoretic. This one is practical. Okay? So theoretical quantile versus practical quantiles. Now, how do you identify the Q quantile of the sample? First, you sort them from the smallest and largest. Then you multiply, if you check this out, you multiply Q, the probability value, with the number of observations and identify the closest integer to that. And when you identify the closest integer, with that index, you choose the sorted order statistics. So when you want to draw a quantile-quantile plot, we have this procedure. We need to determine the order statistics. We need to sort the observations from the smallest and largest. And the ith observation, the ith observation in that sample must be close to I minus 0.5 over n quantile of that distribution. So we need to sort the observations from the smallest to largest. And we also need to calculate the quantiles at I minus 0.5 over n. Actually, the first observation in this sample must be similar to 0.5 over n quantile of that distribution. The second observation must be very close to the 1.5 over n quantile, so and so forth. And after determining these theoretical quantiles with the sample order statistics, we are going to create a plot diagram pairwisely with these observations and the quantile value. So let's practice this in an example so we can understand it better. So we have a sample size of 100 observations, and these observations are already sorted from the smallest to the largest. And let's just say we have drawn the histogram, and the histogram of these 100 observations has looked like a symmetric normal density. And after that, we have estimated the maximum likelihood estimators, the suggested estimators, basically the sample mean and the sample variance. And we have put this hypothesis. So we have the hypothesis of the sample to follow normal distribution with location parameter equal to 0.056 and the variance being equal to 1.176. Now, I have my order statistics as already calculated here. Now, I need to calculate the theoretical quantiles. And in order to calculate the theoretical quantiles, I need to use the inverse CDF of the normal distribution with this formulation. For my first index, 1 minus 0.5 divided by 100. Remember, number of observations is 100. 1 minus 0.5 divided by 100 gives you a 0.005. So I need to find the theoretical quantile of that distribution in the hypothesis with the exact parameters coming from the null hypothesis. And that gives me a minus 2.737. I need to do this for the remaining quantiles, 2, 3, 4, 5, all of them, and I will get minus 2.297 here. And for the last one, as you see, 100 minus 0.5 divided by 100 will give you 0.995, and the theoretical quantile here is going to be 2.85. As you can see, the first value here is not very close to the first value. However, the second value here is a little closer, and the last value is close. However, we need to check if every order statistics is close to the quantile values that we have calculated. And we need to draw the plot diagram for that. And as you can see, the plot diagram here of the observed values and the theoretical quantiles, they seem to form a linear line. And if they form a linear line, my friends, if the plot here gives you almost linear line, then you can say as an expert, these data seem to come from distribution. So this is an informal way of running this hypothesis test. I mean, without needing any p-value, without needing any test statistic, we can check this QQ plot after calculating the theoretical quantiles under the null hypothesis. And we can simply say that according to this QQ plot, these samples seem to follow normal distribution based on the theoretical quantiles. Now, do not expect the points to form an exact line. So this line is good. It is not exactly linear, however, it is good. And do not expect the points to be evenly distributed around line. I mean, do not always think that the values are going to be one large, one small, one large, one small, then line. Sometimes the points can be above the line for a while, and after that they can be below the line for a while. So this may happen as well. And the linearity in the middle ground is much more important than the linearity in the tail. So if you do not observe a linearity in the tails, I'm not saying that this is not a problem. However, if you do not see a linearity in the middle ground, then this is certainly a problem. So in this shape, I get to understand that the null hypothesis can be true.